Hi everyone, this is Hobbi Crochet. Today we are gonna make very little, very small hat. It can be keychain or it could be just like a pocket hug in your pocket. Give it to your daddy, mommy, your teacher. I wanted to show just very quickly all amigurumi I've made in my recent videos. And this is my previous one. It could be used as presents, little ice cream, little ladybird. Those are to put your keys and hide them when it's in your bag. It's a very cute idea. I've got a few of them. This is little piggy, Hello Kitty, Winnie the Pooh, cactus. You put your keys on the ring and then you pull the tail. All these videos will be the link will be in the description below. Little heart. And finally, I wanted to show this is very good for Daddy's Day. Could be like a little keychain. This is beer can. I've got a video how to embroider this beer mug. Have a look. And it's very cute. It's got eyes and glasses. I couldn't find that particular one, but it's a very good idea. Without bottom, you can use it again as your key cozy to hide your keys. Amigurumi circle. Six single crochets. I'm pulling to close. Row 2, 2 single crochets in each stitch. First stitch is always tight. Don't worry about it. Row 3, row 4, 12 single crochets, 1 single crochet in each stitch for 2 rows. After 4 rows, you make chain 1. And cut the yarn. This is one little half. Make the second one exactly the same, but don't cut the yarn. Now we're gonna connect both pieces. I will start with next stitch. And I will make 12 single crochets around one half and then 12 single crochet around next half. I will count 1, 2 and keep going 12 single crochets. 11, and this is my 12th stitch. Now I need to go around second half with 12 stitches and watch out . This is your first stitch. If you go straight to this stitch, you can, and then you will stitch this little hole with this loose end, or you can try to do this all together at once. What I can do, this is my first loop, my first stitch, and I will kind of make this stitch together with the previous one. So I will make, pull the loop from this end, pull the loop from the last stitch, and pull the loop from my first stitch. And do it all together. And this is first stitch on this half. I need to make 11 more. I've done 10, 11, and this is my 12th. And this was connecting round, was round 5. 24 stitches altogether. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So you will have 24 stitches. If it's slightly less or more, don't worry about it, that's fine. You just keep going, or you can undo and count your stitches. So the idea of it is we are making decrease, 4 decreases. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So I want to make decrease between those halves and in the middle on the sides. To achieve this, I want to move the beginning of my row slightly, so this will be my first decrease, those two stitches between. Ideally, it would be 4 single crochets decrease on next row, then it will be 3 single crochets decrease, and so on. But because we always have different amount of stitches every time you do this little thing, so don't worry about counting them. You just make decrease between those halves, and decrease will be on those two stitches. So let's just go ahead and do it, and don't worry about your stitches. Three and four, approximately, I gave you the pattern. So decrease, next decrease will be between those halves. I want to decrease those two stitches, maybe this one and next one. Sometimes it's hard to recognize the stitches. I understand that This stitch is already taken, so this is my next stitch. But honestly, if you lose stitch, it's fine. If you add additional stitch, it's fine. The pattern will still be great. So if I want to make one more single crochet and make decrease on these two loops in between. Good, next decrease will be in the middle of this half. It will be around 3 or 4 single crochets. You just fold it in half and you will see I want to decrease next two stitches. And that's it for this row, because I've already made a decrease on this bit. So next decrease will be again on this bit, between those halves. I will decrease those two stitches. It doesn't matter either you decrease those two stitches or those two stitches, you know, I just want to make 4 decreases in a row. So decrease, then I'm making 1 2 3 and 2 decreases and 1 decrease on this side. Then again find your next stitch. Two and three. And decrease between the halves. Next again, around 3 single crochets it should be. 1 2 and 3. It's approximately half, so decrease. And 3 single crochet to finish this row. I've made 2 and I want to make next decrease. That's fine. Let's have decrease between those halves. It is such a small thing, you can't go wrong with it. So decrease. Again, next decrease will be on this bit. Let's have 2 single crochets. And decrease. And somewhere here in the middle, maybe let's have 2 single crochets again. Sometimes those stitches already getting loose, large, because you are going, you are making decreases. You just watch out for this and decrease. And sometimes they are getting very small. Let's make how many? 1 single crochet and maybe decrease. So you just see how you need your heart goes, how it looks, and you will estimate yourself decreases. If you make 4 decreases in a row, it will look great. The opening is very small. I will put little bit of stuffing. Let's finish this row. I was making decrease and finish the row between the halves. And I want to make next decrease over there. You will just keep going around till you've got a very small amount of stitches. Next row I will make one single crochet and decrease. And again, one single crochet and decrease. One single crochet and decrease. So this is approximate pattern. If it goes one, two more stitches away from this pattern, that will be absolutely fine. The hat looks great and I'm sure everyone would love it. Now I've got maybe just a few stitches left. I want to make decrease because I'm literally in the middle of those halves. So I just making decrease and maybe again decrease. You just see how you go. And I struggle to make another decrease. If you struggle to pick the front loop, pick both loops and pull the loop. And make just a ordinary decrease. Ordinary decrease you make I struggle to do even ordinary decrease, so it will be the end. Now I'm pulling the yarn and I will finish it with a darning needle. This is a little bit too large, but anyway, you want to pick, ideally you want to pick front loops, that's how your job will look neater. If you pull front loops only, but if you can't, that will be just fine. Pull it and make it look like a heart. Good looking little heart. To finish this off, I will make a knot and hide this end. and the heart is ready. Thank you for watching.